Create a new program in IEC 61131-3 Red Lion Workbench and run on ST-IPm-8460. Red Lion Workbench is a fully featured IEC 61131-3 compliant programming editor, used to create programs and communicate to slave devices with your ST-IPm-8460 RTU. We will show you how to configure the RTU and IO module, create a new Red Lion Workbench project, set up field bus communication from the RTU to the IO module over Modbus TCP master. Then, download the new program to the RTU. Before you start, download and install the toolkit and Red Lion Workbench at www.redlion.net. Create a new IO toolkit project and add the RTU and EtherTrack 2 IO module to the project. Okay, let's go. We'll start off by configuring the RTU and creating a new Red Lion Workbench project. In the IO toolkit project file, click on the dialog button next to the RTU. Click on the Ports tab to see the IP address and serial port parameters. Note that the IP address for interface 1 is 10.1.0.1. We will use this interface to download the program. Also note the IP address for interface 2 is 192.168.0.1. We will use this interface with its onboard switch to communicate to the EtherTrack 2 module. Double-click on the IP address to configure it. Click on the Advanced button to configure the subnet mask for both interfaces. In this network, we will use Class C addressing. Next, click on the Advanced tab and select the Red Lion Workbench radio button to enable the runtime. Load this configuration to the RTU by clicking on the Load button on the toolbar. Now, we'll configure the EtherTrack 2 by clicking on the Dialog button. Click on Ethernet in the Tree Views window to configure the IP address. Notice that the IP address we have selected here is 192.168.0.2. Set the subnet mask to Class C, which is compatible with Interface 2 on the RTU. The fourth digit in the IP address, by default, matches the slave address, which is 2. Load this configuration by clicking the Load button on the toolbar. Now, launch the Red Lion Workbench by clicking on the icon in the toolbar. To create a new project in the Red Lion Workbench, click on File and go to New Project List. Then, click on File and go to New Project. Select Project in the list. Create your project name. Select the language for the first program. Under Communications, set the IP address for the RTU. We'll match the IP address of Interface 1 in the RTU configuration. Then, select T5 Runtime. In the Protocols list, we'll select Modbus Master so we can query the slave EtherTrack 2 module. Communication to the EtherTrack 2 modules and other Modbus slave devices can be set up using the Fieldbus configuration. Open the Fieldbus configuration on the toolbar. Click on Insert Master Port. Now, enter the IP address of the EtherTrack 2. Notice the port number and protocol are configurable, although for the EtherTrack 2 module, we will stick with defaults. Click on Insert Slave Data Block. Enter a description. Set the slave address to 2, which matches the EtherTrack 2 module. To read the discrete inputs on the I/O module, we'll select Read Input Bits. For discrete outputs, use coil bits. For analog inputs and counters, use input registers. For analog outputs and TPO registers, use holding registers. Activate requests when the variable is called in the program with the onCall option. Write requests may be activated each time the variable changes with the onChange option. Check the Declare Variables checkbox and enter a prefix. Leave the percent symbol to automatically create variable names. Discrete input variables will automatically be created and added to the global variable list. Now, let's create a new program, download it to the RTU, and go online. Double-click on the main program to start programming. In the Blocks window on the right, open the All folder. Right-click on any block to access Help and other options. Drag the block into the main editor window. Go to the Global Variables list in Variable Editor window. Drag the variables into an empty variable. Create a new variable by double-clicking on the empty variable. Enter a name. The default parameters for the new variable will match what is required for that block. Now, we are ready to build the program. Click on the Build icon. The output window below will show the status of the build, including any errors, plus what and where the errors are. Go online with the RTU and download the program and field bus configuration by clicking on the Online button. Notice that the communication parameters and status are listed in the status bar below. Now, when a voltage is applied to the discrete inputs on the EtherTrack 2, their status is reflected in the online debugger. Programming and communicating via Modbus are just a few of the things you can do with the ST-IPm-8460 RTU and the Red Lion Workbench. For more information, go to support.redlion.net.